Hello, Aquarius. Elsie here to do your reading. It is for the week ahead, my friends. How are you? Thank you so much for stopping in here, Aquarius. I appreciate you. If you are brand new and you've never been here before, well, welcome here. I hope you will hit the subscription button down here, and I hope you will hit the bell button as well so you know when I'm uploading. It was a little bit of an off week this week. Usually I do this reading for the Aquarius signs. The air signs are usually on a Thursday, running a little bit behind, but haven't forgotten about you, Aquarius. Here we are. We are going to do something a little bit different for the week ahead, Aquarius. We're going to look at three hands. So we're gonna throw three different hands, three different decks, and find out what's going on for you. Whatever comes out, comes out. And sometimes those three hands are going to relate to each other. They might be the ending and the continuing of the same story. And sometimes it's three separate readings. So this is my way of trying to get more of your energies into these readings here. Let's find out what's going on for you in the week ahead, Aquarius. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. Tell me what's going on for Aquarius in the week ahead, please. Tell me about Aquarius. What is coming up for Aquarius next week? We have the King of Cups. Why is that? With the Knight of Pentacles, it feels like there is some sort of either a person or emotional things. Maybe it feels like you're showing me your softer side, I want to say. Ooh, okay. When I said those words just now, I heard the song in my head called Bitch. Look, I'm not calling you that. But in that song, she says, it must have been a relief for you to see the softer side. So I feel like you do have a softer side, but I feel like you're really slow at showing it with the Knight of Pentacles here. Yesterday I cried. You must be relieved to see that I had a softer side. Something like that. And I honestly forget who the name of the lady is that sings it, but the song is called Bitch. All right, let's find out what else is going on here. There might be something in those lyrics. That's why I always will mention the songs that come to me in my clairaudience. I'll always give it to you. All right, yeah. So it does feel like it does feel like there is a softer side. And I want to say, Aquarius, just from that clairaudience that I just got from that song, it feels like you're scared to show the softer side. That's what it looks like here. And it might be because you've been hurt in divulging or bringing your feelings to the surface. Maybe you've been hurt before. But the King of Cups is a worry. And the worry is that people are going to find out that I'm far more sensitive. I'm far more deep and easy to hurt underneath the hard exterior. And so I feel like it takes you a really long while with the Knight of Pentacles. It takes you a really long while to show someone on the surface exactly who you are emotionally. And I feel like this has always been a hardship for you with the Nine of Swords here. It's always been something that you worried about or something that's come into that's come into play in relationships, whether they're platonic or romantic, that people see you as someone who's very stoic on the surface, someone who is not really showing their feeling here. We do have the King of Pentacles in the future. We'll talk about that in just a moment. I want to say that for some of you, I feel like this is about to change. I feel like you're about to show someone your softer side, I want to say. And we do have the Empress and the Emperor here. I do feel like there are two people who are on the same vibration in life. And although I feel that you are on the same vibration, I feel for you, Aquarius, whether you're feminine or masculine, you're both represented here. Whether you're feminine or masculine, I feel like it worries you to show someone your vulnerability or to show someone your softer side. I feel like you do present to people in your life, platonic or romantic, as the Emperor or as the Empress. Now, the Emperor is the King of Cups. And so this sort of rings true if you are the masculine leaning energy, but please remember that the Emperor also has feminine energy. And so someone asked a really great question in the comments the other day. And the really great question I thought was, are we talking about men or women? Well, we're not talking about what's on the outside. I don't really care what sort of genitals you have or what your capsule looks like. I'm talking about what's going on inside emotionally, what's going inside energetically. So we're talking about feminines and masculines. This emperor is masculine leaning, this empress is feminine leaning, but the empress has masculine energy. There must always be a balance in the universe, and the emperor has feminine energy, because 100% masculinity is toxic and 100% femininity is toxic. So there always must be a balance, right? So I do feel like what's about to change is that I feel like you're about to meet someone who is on your vibration, Aquarius. I feel like it worries you, right? The Emperor still has the Nine of Swords, worried about showing the softer side. That's what it feels like here. So I could be talking about a feminine or a masculine. I feel like the Empress, if I am speaking to the masculine, I feel like the Empress is going to change everything for you, because this person is going to understand you as the King of Swords, right? This person's going to understand you as the Aquarius energy, because this Empress is the Queen of Swords and gets it, right? She has this energy as well of being very honest and truthful, and someone who is very invested in truth and honesty and transparency, just like you, right? The Emperor is also the King of Swords. All right. So I feel like what is changing is I feel like someone is about to catch up with you. I don't necessarily know that you know this person. I'm not feeling that right now. So it does feel like this is probably a new connection. But if you are the masculine, I feel like when you meet the Empress, even though you are the Emperor, that the Empress intimidates you just a little bit, or makes you a bit nervous, because you know that in order to keep the Empress, you're going to have to show your softer side, because the Empress is the Queen of Cups, and she will recognize and honor the softer side. All right, tell me what is changing here for Aquarius, please. We do have the Eight of Cups. We have the Nine of Pentacles and the Eight of Swords. I feel like you're walking away from things that no longer serve you. And I think what has not served you in the past, Aquarius, is trying to pretend that you're all tough on the surface and not letting anybody in. I honestly don't think that that's a way that that you can really lead a meaningful life. If you can't reach to the vulnerability, the depths of the King of Cups, it can be a pretty surface life. And we really can't dive deep with anyone if we don't know the energy of the King of Cups. So I feel like you're done settling for situations that get you stuck in your head, and I feel like you're trying to find the confidence, right, with the Nine of Pentacles. You could be single, you don't have to be, but Nine of Pentacles, and then we have one in the hand of the Knight, and the Knight is moving very patiently, very slowly, being very careful about the feelings I show on the surface. So I feel like you are going to find some confidence at some point when the Wheel of Fortune shows up, because the wheel is about, you know, cycles, right? And it's time for the cycle to change. And that's what the Wheel of Fortune is about. I feel like you are going to meet someone. If you are the Emperor, you'll meet the Empress, and the Empress will meet the Emperor. Take it as it resonates for you. But I feel like this person is going to make you show your softer side. But I feel like this person is going to help you protect that softer side. So that means that this Empress doesn't need for you to show the King of Cups energy to everybody, but the Empress is going to want you to dig deep into this energy in order to keep this person around, because the Empress is balanced in all of her energies. And if you are the Emperor and you are in the upright and you're balanced in all of your energies, that means you're going to have to pay attention to the King of Cups energy as well. I feel like you've gone years, probably 10 years, maybe even more, with not showing people emotions on the surface. This is really gonna, you know, trouble you. It's going to keep you stuck in this cycle here. And to me, the Nine of Swords is being stuck in a cycle because you can't see your own pattern. It's time to wake up and see your pattern. The King can see anything, the King of Cups, because this is the highly psychic energy of the zodiac, right? So what is changing here? Tell me what's changing. We've got the Queen of Pentacles, we've got the Page of Wands, and we have the Seven of Swords. So I feel like you're moving away from being very cautious or overly cautious to a place of wanting to settle down. I feel that happens when you meet your Emperor or your Empress. And it feels like this person makes you feel like a kid again. So it feels like they they are willing to accept and see you on the surface for who you are. I feel like what you do conceal from people, you conceal from people that you are actually fun and flirty. And, you know, I feel like you are kind of childlike. And I don't mean that in a derogatory way. I mean that you have the ability to get out there on the swings and the slide with the kids. Do you know what I mean? It feels like that sort of energy. I want to say that when you decide that you are going to show your softer side, that is when you will meet this emperor or the empress. Tell me about these two. We have the Page of Cups, we have the Hanged Man and the Hermit. You're going to meet this person by surprise. It's probably going to be out somewhere social. You're going to meet them by surprise, but I feel like you're going to meet them through manifestation, because it does feel like with the Hermit energy here, it's your wisdom the Empress will attract the Emperor, or vice versa. It feels like you've been in this energy of trying to see a different perspective. And I think it's that, you know, you have to show your softer side. So I feel like for some of you, you will be meeting the person who is your energetic match. Whether they are an Emperor or an Empress, you will be meeting, you know, this is all the Queens and all the Kings. You will be meeting someone who is your energetic match. Something is about to begin in the 3D here. There is an opportunity that's coming, and it will come in with a tower. So I feel like you meet the Emperor or the Empress through a situation that you had not planned. So in a public space, maybe it's a fender bender, maybe you bump into them in a line somewhere, maybe you throw your coffee at them by accident when you're falling to the ground. It feels like it's going to be something like that, and you don't see it coming, my friend, but it is the moment of alchemy here. It's the moment of alchemy that something sort of, you know, this is surprising, right? Like this person here who is the Gemini energy just kind of runs in and throws all the words at you and lets you sort them out. And I feel like it's going to be something like that, bumping into somebody and saying, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do that. And, you know, something, it's an awkward beginning with this person. So we do have Virgo. We do have Piscean energy. We have Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. We have Taurus and Libra, Scorpio, Taurus, Aquarius, Leo. We have Aries. We have Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer, and Virgo, and more Scorpio energy. All right. Let's go to the second hand, Aquarius. Let's find out what's going on. Let's go to the second hand for Aquarius. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. I just looked at the timer and it was 12:22. So that could be an angel number for you, or that number may mean something to you. It tells me that this is the beginning of a lot of balance. Ones are about the beginning of something, and twos are about balance and choices. All right, tell me about the second hand. Tell me what else Aquarius needs to know, please. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. Tell me what Aquarius needs to know. We do have the Ace of Swords. Interesting. So there is something coming up that is brand new. We're on a brand new path intellectually, possibly about to get some clarity on something here, about to have a conversation. We do have the Two of Wands. What else do we have here, please? We have the Six of Pentacles. I feel like there is a conversation coming up between you and somebody in the Pentacle world. So it doesn't have to be romantic. There's nothing here that indicates that this is romantic. I'm going to say, please prepare. That's what the Two of Wands is, preparing to make a decision. I feel like you are preparing to make a decision, but I want to say the decision's going to be tough. It feels like this person is kind of tied down. And that could mean a bunch of things for a bunch of people on a bunch of different timelines. But for me, as I'm reading this, it feels like you're about to have a conversation, a reciprocal conversation, where there's somebody who you wish to give something to. You wish to give somebody clarity. You wish to share a lot of clarity with someone who maybe shared clarity with you in the past. We also have the Justice card. We have the Knight of Swords. Yeah, there is going to be communication here. I feel like the person you'll be communicating with is someone that you don't necessarily trust. It feels like this person, I want to say that the Knight of Swords pointing directly at the Six of Pentacles tells me that somebody here is used to kind of just charging in and using the smokescreen of charity, I want to say. So this person is a person who maybe How can I say? This feels like this person is maybe somebody who punishes people with silence, but then when they see them again, they come in with gifts of words, gifts that are material. So they say good things. They talk about, you know, all the ways in which we can grow together in the pentacle world. It does feel like you are about to find some justice here by opening up this conversation. And I feel it is you that will open up this conversation. But what I want to say is that this person who is in the Six of Pentacles, you could be dealing with an earth sign or maybe a Libra. Take it as it resonates for you here. But it feels like this person is very engaged in charity or in teaching, someone who's really into giving reciprocal energy, but this person is into giving it to everyone, not just you. And so I feel like you are sort of rushing in with a bunch of words here. And we've got 2, 3, 4, maybe after some healing has been done. The Emperor is on the bottom of the deck with the Ace of Pentacles. You may be a masculine, but please understand that the masculine energy, the masculine leaning energy is with the Emperor, but the Emperor also has feminine energy, right? There has to be a balance in all things. It's the law of the universe. So I do feel that that there is a conversation that you want to open up here with somebody who you know is going to give you reciprocity. It feels like you do want that soon. It feels like you want to charge in. But I want to say that there is somebody here that doesn't trust the other one. I feel like either you are really like not very trusting, Aquarius, or maybe you just don't trust this person. We do have the energy of it feels to me like with this person who is like rushing in and throwing words at you, it's almost like it's a smokescreen. It's like if I catch Aquarius off guard and give them a gift or give them some charity or charitable words, that you're going to forget about all the hardships that had transpired with this person. It feels like maybe this person is ready to make a very balanced decision about something that has been in their head for a while. Tell me about the Ace of Swords. We've got the Seven of Swords. I was saying it felt like somebody is like not being completely truthful, and it's almost like they throw the words at you and give you reciprocity in the 3D world as sort of a smokescreen. It's like they don't want to talk about what happened in the past. We do have the Strength card, and the Emperor comes back out. So the Seven of Swords, of course, is the liar, the deceit, or something. If it's not a lie, somebody's keeping something under the surface. It's not always bad, but they are holding back. And I feel like there is somebody here who is in their Emperor energy. And so I feel what the reason that somebody is charging in is because they're very confident, solid and sturdy. They're used to getting their own way. They're, you know, somebody who is used to people obeying and following. So I feel like they come at you with a bunch of words and throw them at you. It's almost like a smokescreen. Like they start pelting you with conversation and maybe gifts, possibly. But it feels like, it almost feels like this is the way this person says sorry, I want to say. Tell me about justice, please, and the Two of Swords. It feels like somebody's going to get some karmic justice here, that the truth is going to be said about something. Something that had you stuck in your head, something that was heartbreaking, or that disappointed you, or didn't feel good with this person. It feels like you haven't spoken with them in a while, but they're coming in because they want to have this balance with you here. Yeah, it could be the Queen of Wands. We do have the Queen of Wands here, who is Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, feminine or masculine, even though there's a woman on the picture. We do have the Eight of Wands, which tells me the Queen of Wands might be the person who is sending a message to you. That might be what is opening this conversation. We do have the Page of Pentacles. This is already something that is growing in the 3D, and I feel like you don't see it. It is going to grow from the Page of Pentacles to the Ten of Pentacles, but it's going to take time. It's going to take years. Understand that as a reader, I see Pentacles as years. So it could take this person years to come out of their shell. This person here is someone who sort of runs after the shiny thing, and I think to them, you are the shiny thing. Whether you're feminine or masculine, that the fact that you hold back and you don't tell your truth and you don't really, you know, say things on the surface right away, I think attracts this person in their fire. They see you as a bit of a challenge, Aquarius. Now, this could indicate that something is growing and you haven't seen this person in 10 years, but I feel like the intention of the Queen is to find a long-term relationship here, and I feel like this person is coming toward you to talk about that. So this might be someone that you already know for some of you. We do have the High Priestess, the Hermit, and the Four of Swords. This Queen, I feel, has been spending some time in healing or healing of the mind. Somebody has been giving themselves a mental break. So if you haven't heard from them and there's been no communication, it's because they're in the Four of Swords and that the Hermit energy. They've been trying to find their wisdom. You can see that the Hermit has got the candle, which is their light, looking over at the Four of Wands. And so I feel that there's somebody here who's either been in therapy or they're now aware of how they move in the 3D. They are somebody who I feel has been taking time to heal, and they're also now very in touch with their inner psychic, like their psychic intuitive energy is right on point. These two cards tell me that it's been nothing but silence between you, and I feel like the silence is about to break, my friend. There we go. But it could start out an argument. Somebody here is kind of, you know, a force to be reckoned with. The Queen of Swords can be, you know, someone who's a little bit snarky or snide. When she's in the reverse, she's sarcastic. Like, you know, it's like, oh, well, it's been a while since I saw you. What are you, out of money? Do you know what I mean? Like, it's like a, like, it feels like that. So I don't know if that's you or them, because this is air energy, but, you know, it feels like it could be something like that that comes to the surface. When this person comes in and throws their energy at you, you're like, oh, you're back. What are you, out of cash? Like, it feels like something like that. So it feels like it is somebody that you know that maybe you've had words with in the past. We have Piscean energy tells me that there's been silence, but you also know that they're coming. You know that they're on the approach. I've always said that you're kind of psychic, Aquarius. So we have Hermit energy, which is Virgo. We have Piscean energy. We have Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. We have more Aries and Gemini energy. We do have Leo energy as well. Right. One more hand for you, my friend. One more for Aquarius. Tell me what else Aquarius needs to know, please, about the week ahead. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. Aquarius, it's always going to be for the week ahead whenever you find it. No matter if you find it today, tomorrow, or next year, it's always going to be for the week ahead. Tell me about Aquarius. What else do we need to know about Aquarius energy? What have we got here? Seven of Cups. There is some sort of a decision that you're trying to make currently, and it has to do with feelings. It feels like it's an emotional decision that you're trying to make. It feels like it's confusing. You're not really sure what to do. I feel like the path is, yeah, like you feel like it's not really real. Like you feel like it's an illusion. The Ace of Wands is here and the Four of Cups is here. Yeah, so the Four of Cups is like, am I safer just staying in the Four of Cups and not accepting any cups here? Because it feels like the Seven is like the overwhelm or the confusion. It feels like you are trying to figure out whether or not it's time to find a new path of passion. Now, this doesn't have to be meaning that you're going out with someone or that you are looking for love, but this is an exciting, creative way to begin a new path, essentially. And I feel like you have been hesitating going out on this path because you feel like the Four of Cups is a really comfortable place for you right now. And although it's a place of redundancy, look, don't build your house there. Just pop a tent if you need to. But it is a place where there is stability of the emotions. And I feel like you probably have issues showing emotions on the surface. Unless you got some crazy water in the Moon and the Rising or Venus, I feel like you have a hard time with the emotions. We've got the Lovers. I saw that as I was shuffling. I saw it twice. We have the Queen of Pentacles. Windows are open, by the way, so you're going to hear a little bit of road noise. We do have the Queen of Pentacles. What else? So there's a choice to make, my friend. I feel like there is a choice to make here, a couple of them, actually. It feels like there is a choice in, I feel like somebody is going to ask you out somewhere, or you're going to be invited to some sort of social gathering. It feels like a celebration is coming. And you're going to have to make a choice as to whether you're going to ignore this invitation and go on your own path alone, or whether you're going to take this invitation. The person who gives the invitation could be someone who is a Gemini, possibly a Taurus, a Virgo, a Capricorn, maybe a water sign, right? Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer, or possibly we do have fire here, right? So kind of everybody's represented here. I want to say that this person, this Queen of Pentacles here, is feeling in a celebratory mood. And it could be because of some sort of an accomplishment she's had in the 3D. I also feel like this person's been thinking about you or feeling your emotions, because it feels like you're very confused in your emotions right now. This person is somebody who has their eyes closed. And whenever somebody has their eyes closed, it's always about what they feel, the vibrations, right? So when our eyes are closed or covered, then we start to feel things, we feel energies, we feel emotions, we smell the earth, we smell and hear, and you know, those other senses become far more acute. So I feel like this person has been trying to feel you out energetically from a distance. Somebody here might be inviting you out. Tell me about the Three of Cups, please. Tell me about the Three of Cups. We have the Ace of Cups, we have the Two of Swords, and we do have the Six of Pentacles. You do have to make some type of a choice, which I think you're going to kind of agonize over. We did see the Two of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. Now we see the Two of Swords. It's all about getting out of your head enough to make some sort of a decision to give reciprocity to this Queen of Pentacles, whether they are feminine or masculine. We do have the Ace of Cups, so I feel like it's like the reason you don't want to go is because I think you're at the part right now where you're blocking love, or you're just not interested in being social or being out with people. I want to say that this person could be a soulmate. Absolutely, it could be for some of you. But I really do feel the Lover's card is telling me that you're about to make a choice emotionally. And whether or not it's about a relationship, I feel like the closest decision you'll make is probably about whether or not you're going to go out there and show your emotions to other people, or whether you're going to go on this path alone. Tell me about the Ace of Wands, please. Tell me about the Ace of Wands, and what's the decision for Aquarius? What will they be doing here? What's the decision? What's the choice? We have the Eight of Pentacles. We have the Ace of Swords, and we have the Nine of Pentacles. So I feel like you're going to muster up your confidence and answer the text or answer the call, I feel. Even though you're feeling confused, not sure what to do, emotionally overwhelmed, like when I feel like you've been trying to, this could be a work function or a work party here. We do have the Eight of Pentacles. But for some of you, you are someone who is in business for yourself. So it could be a previous employer, people from your previous employer that you still keep in contact with. Somebody from there could be communicating with you. The Ace of Swords is here. You're going to get all the clarity that you need. And I feel like what you're going to do is feel confident enough to pick up the phone or to send the text back here. We do have the Death card in reverse. We do have the Empress, and we have the Two of Wands. Okay, so I feel like you need to make a choice. Again, we've got the third two that's shown up here, and the only two that we haven't seen yet is the Two of Cups. So I don't feel like this is a choice in love. I feel like this is a choice of passion. I feel like you need to prepare to make a decision to go out on some type of adventure, because if you answer yes to the Three of Cups, I do believe you're going to bump into the Empress. And I want to say that if you're still the person who's still avoiding change, whatever change it is, it could be that you still haven't yet seen your magic, or possibly you're someone who's healing, or is someone who keeps everything under the surface and is not willing to share. Maybe you're only willing to share a little bit, but it does feel like you need to accomplish some sort of transformation. And you're holding off the transformation. It feels like you're holding off this transformation, and that might be why some of you will say no to the invitation, and you'll just go out on this path of passion by yourself. Some of you are gonna think about it for a little bit. You're gonna hesitate, beat yourself up about it, but I think you will end up giving some sort of a decision. So, you know, because the King of Swords makes the decision no matter what, right? So it's always the decision that's best for everyone involved, not just for the King. The King of Swords is somebody who always has the big idea, right? But I do feel like it's you, right? The Aquarius energy, it's you that is holding back or beating yourself up about, what if I don't, you know, take this invitation? I feel like you're going to hang there for a little while. For some of you, it could be to go to a wedding. And maybe somebody wants you to be a plus one at a wedding, and that's what the communication is about. Somebody might be about to enter into a long-term relationship. Like, I mean, this is, it feels to me like you're being asked to go to a wedding as a plus one, or can you come with the family or something like that. So it does feel like there is something coming up in the future here that you're going to have to make a very clear and honest decision about whether you're going to go or not. Some of you, I feel, will just hang there and not give an answer. But most of you, I think, are going to pick up the phone out of confidence and speak to them just as the King of Swords would. Look, I don't feel like this is an opportunity for me. I'm not really sure if I want to go to a wedding. I don't want to be in a public place where I have to pretend I like people around me and socialize. Like, that's the King of Swords energy, right? So I feel like for some of you, you might have water energy, and you might sort of get into your psychic intuition and figure out, you know, if maybe this is time to make a change. Maybe you don't usually accept the invitation to be somebody's plus one or go to a social thing, or maybe that's not you. But I feel like if it's not you, it's because you're right here with the Death card in reverse. You're not willing to change. And if you're not willing to change, that means that things for you aren't changing, and that's why I don't see the Wheel of Fortune here. So I feel like you need to be the one to make change. If you're the person who doesn't usually go out and take invitations like this, I feel like if you want to meet this Empress, who could possibly be someone who really affects your life in a big way, because when the Empress is in the room, so are all the Queens, and the Empress is the drop of water in the ocean, and everyone around her is always going to benefit. So I feel like this person, whether they are a romantic interest in your life, maybe this is someone who is a friend, maybe someone that you'll meet that you don't necessarily have an interest in, but this person is about to bless your life because this person is in their abundance. So I feel like for some of you, you will meet the Empress because you're willing to change. You're willing to change your mind about how you deal in a situation like this. And for some of you, you just won't. You'll be hanging in this hanged man energy. I'm going to go for now. Thank you so much for being here, Aquarius. I appreciate you. I'm out for now. I'll be back though, because I'm always back. Love you guys. Bye-bye.